three small hot brews McCafe coffee on National Coffee Day, which I had no idea is National Coffee Day. Awesome.
Taxi!
It's been an interesting morning so far. I turned on my tablet and I was second in line in my area, which is very rare. There's hardly ever a time where I'm second in line at my house. But you know, I sat there for a while and I was second in line for a while. So I decided there were two calls on the board. There was a one to the east side and one to Midwest City. And I really felt like I should take the one to the east side, but I took the one to Midwest City, and the one to Midwest City drove all the way there, and they canceled on me. And so then I immediately get the one to the east side. So I called the guy, and he said, "Well, just go ahead and come on, but if I get another ride, then I'll let you know." And I said, "Okay." So that's the way it's been this morning. Sitting in a Walmart parking lot, 4 o'clock in the morning. I've had one customer today and got some breakfast and some free coffee, National Coffee Day. And so I've just been kind of hanging out, kind of slow today, but this is something that's pretty cool. You see, right here, just in my line of sight, I have three RVs just boondocking, which means that they're parking in for free. And that's something that I've been thinking about a lot lately. As much as I love to travel, and as much as Stacy loves to travel, and I just feel led to travel the country, teaching God's word to whomever God puts in my path, and I don't know how that all makes sense and how it all works, but I would love to get myself an RV and just travel, but. As much as I would love that, I know that as much as I would love that, that's my desire. And sometimes my desires and God's desires don't match. And so I have to always be sure that what I'm doing is what God wants me to do. Matthew 6, 19 through 34 is just incredible scripture. It's incredible teaching by Jesus. And, you know, basically he says, why are you worried about what you're going to wear and what you're going to eat and you know, your necessities. Why are you worried about all these things in life? He said, look at the birds of the air. You know, they don't have to work. They don't have to toil. And not that we don't need to work, you understand, but if you get down to the end of it, you see the key here is this. He says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you. And that's the important thing, isn't it? To seek first the kingdom of God, and he will take care of you. God will take care of you, but you have to be seeking him. And so, as much as I would love to travel and do what these guys are doing right here, I have to do what God wants me to do first. So, that's what we'll be doing. Well, I'm sitting here at the famous Cattleman's Restaurant. If you've ever been to Oklahoma City, probably heard of it. Maybe you've come here. I had breakfast here once. It was decent breakfast. Never really eaten here dinner time or anything like that, so couldn't attest to their steak quality, but some people say it's good, some people say it's overrated. I wouldn't know. It's 5:18 in the morning, so I've had a few calls. It's going all right. I've been working for about 2 hours now. I had a couple of times where I really just ran around a lot, didn't really accomplish a whole lot, but that's my fault. Just had a guy who picked him up out of rehab, took him to community house rehab. Young guy. Was on heroin, and he's fighting it. He's fighting this battle as hard as he possibly can to get off it and to not lose his life. And you know, I've been there before. I quit everything you could do, you know, and the best advice I could give him was that this life that you're living, it's currency, you know, it's currency, and it's what you spend it on that makes the difference. You spend it on pleasing yourself, it's going to buy you nothing. You got to remember that, guys. I'm not going to say that I don't have hard times. We all have hard times. There are times whenever I just struggle to make any money in this job. But I stay positive through it out because I know that I'm being obedient to God and doing what I'm supposed to do. And like today, you know, today I have to go get a flu shot at 1 o'clock in Edmond. The reality is I have to be done working by, say, 8:30 to 9 o'clock so I can go shopping for lunch and dinner. And then I can go home and take a nap because I am very tired. And then I have to, you know, go to Edmond to get the flu shot. And so I need to make some more money. Well, I just get a call. I see a call that is zoned incorrectly. It's supposed to be a 900 call, which is something that everybody in the world wants. When you see a 900 call come up on the board, you bid on it. And you just pray to God that you get it. They don't come up often because they're big calls. Anyway, this one was zoned as an 80, which is right by my house, and I wasn't too far away, so I grabbed it, and the first thing I see is fixed rate of $63, and I think, wow, that's something, and I look at the address, and it's Southwest 27th Street, which is close to my house, but in El Reno, so... No, it's not zoned correctly, and it's El Reno, and $63 trip. So, I called the customer, told them how far away I was, and how long it was going to take me to get there. They were fine with that. I'm on my way to it, and I just really praise God for this blessing, because it's going to put me at right around my needs for the day, as far as you know, bills and everything I have to pay. So God is good. Just be obedient to Him, and He will take care of you. But you have to walk in His path. It's important. So I got this message. Let's see here.
With the fire diversion unit, my office has been appointed to rectify this case. Will they involve your name, your telephone number, and social security number as well?
Sure.
I strongly advise you return this call immediately for further information on this time-sensitive legal matter. Call me or my associates immediately at 216-352-1795. Again, this is an urgent matter that does require your immediate attention. Thank you and have a good day.
Okay, so let's just go ahead and check it out. Try call them again. I keep getting these calls. They want me to give them my name, social security number, sure. Yeah, I just got a call with a message. I wanted to see what this was about.
Give me one second. Let me see. They're doing trace and locate efforts for it. Looks like they're trying to reach a subject by the name of Misty Collette.
Yep. You know what? I keep getting phone calls and text messages for Misty. I'm not Misty.
Your number, sir. Have a good day.
Thank you. Oh. Misty. I know a Misty. It's not this Misty. If it was this Misty, I'd be mad at her. But she's a pretty cool chick, so I'm not mad at her. I keep getting calls, Misty. So I just met the most interesting couple. I went and picked them up in El Reno and brought them all the way over to the South Side, close to the airport, to pick up a rental car. They're traveling from California to Massachusetts. She's moving home. He's helping her. And really, really nice people. She's a worship leader. She was a worship leader at a church in in California, and God's called her back home to Massachusetts, and oh, they were just so friendly, you know. And sometimes, most times, I would say I have people in here who just don't want to talk much. They kind of just want to sit there and be quiet, and that gets a little bit old sometimes. Sometimes I really do enjoy a good conversation. So that was a good conversation. I just enjoyed them very, very much. They're great people. And so my day is over, and I'm just going to go ahead and end the day by talking a little bit about my opinions on Uber. Okay, so my opinion on Uber is that it is not a good system for the drivers. Now, I drove Uber about a year ago. I gave up the taxi. It was actually in November, so not quite a year ago, but I gave up the taxi for a week, and I went out with our personal vehicle and drove Uber, and I did not do well with it. And of course, the thing is, I had the lowest option as far as vehicles go. I didn't have a 6-passenger vehicle, so I could only get paid so much money. But so I got paid about 70 cents a mile. Now, out of that, I had to take my gas, my maintenance, depreciation, the car payment, insurance, all of the expenses out of that, which equals out typically to 35 to 40 cents a mile. So let's say conservatively, or actually it's probably not conservative, but let's just say I made 25 cents a mile, paid mile. Now, I'm not talking about the mileage it takes to go from the time I get the call to pick up the customer, or the mileage it takes in between customers, to just the miles that the customer's in my car. And so, say I get a call to go pick up somebody that's 10 minutes away. Alright, so I drive 5 miles to get them, pick them up, and now I have to wait, say, 5 minutes before they actually come out. It's hard to find them. Sometimes that's just the way it is. So now I'm 15 minutes in, 5 miles in, I pick up the person, I take them another 4 miles, that takes another 15 minutes, let's say. So now we're 30 minutes in, I've gotten paid $1. $1 for 30 minutes. That's not good. It's just not good. Now, if it's surging and they're charging the customers way too much money, then you do good. But you really can't count on that. I it was a very hard thing for me to do. I just didn't make any money, and they just don't pay their drivers well enough. It's not a good deal for the drivers. It's a great deal for the customers, and I wish that as a cab we could afford to charge what Uber charges. But the fact of the matter is that it costs a lot of money to operate a taxi. A lot of money. Just a quick breakdown of my expenses every week. I pay the company a tariff of $280 a week. It's actually $380 a week because Stacy drives for me. So $380 a week. We spend $200 a week roughly in fuel. So we're at $580 a week. Then I have a loan payment right now for the tax of the car I'm buying from them of $185 a week, and then I have maintenance, miscellaneous maintenance, usually around $70 a week. Altogether, with everything told, it's between $800 and $850 a week that I have to pay for the ability to use this car, the ability to pick people up as a taxi. So break that down between Stacy and I both, it's $425 a week. That's not a bad deal, considering that as a driver, independent driver without Stacy, it was a lot more. I had to make something like $600 a week just for myself, and that's a lot of money to make. I would have to work between 10 and 12 hours a day, 6 days a week, to make the money. So 60 to 70 hours a week is what I would have to make any sort of real good income above my expenses. So right now, it costs $2 a mile to take a taxi. It's $2.75 to start, $2 a mile, 50 cents a minute wait time. That's a lot of money, I understand, but again, I have to make $800 to $850 a week before I make an income. So I don't apologize anymore for the cost of taxis. Unfortunately, it's expensive. It just is expensive to operate a taxi. And it's expensive to operate any for-hire vehicle. So taxi, Uber, whatnot, it is expensive. So if you're driving an Uber car, It's expensive to drive for Uber. It just is. And so you're not getting paid very well unless you get a lot of surges and you get really lucky with good calls. And honestly, it wasn't the right thing for me, so I didn't do it. That's my opinion on Uber.
Taxi!
So I'm about to play my new introduction for my Taxicab Chronicle videos for my biggest critics. Say hi, girls.
Hi.
And we're going to see what they think about it. Push play, Willow. Our river's fine.
Taxi!
I think of it.
I think it's love. I think I love it.
You love it?
Yeah, I love it too.
You love it?
Yeah, I like it really, really good.
Just you need to put more talking to it.
More talking to it?
Yeah.
Maybe next time.